Interview and job search strategies at work. Today is the 30th anniversary of the World Wide Web, which was founded by, or invented, if you will, Tim Berners-Lee. So Tim Berners-Lee, you know, awesome person, obviously, right? And there's another part to the story, actually, that you probably don't know about. World Wide Web is just one component. Without a computer, it's not going to work. And without transistors, none of that's going to work at all. And the history, really, of the internet, or technology, if you will, in that regard, goes back to the 1950s, when William Barden, William Shockley, and another gentleman made the transistor. So the story goes this way. William Shockley, Dr. Shockley, won the Nobel laureate. But before he did that, him and three other people, actually, or two other people won the Nobel laureate. But he started Shockley Semiconductor in the Silicon Valley. And he got the loan, well, he got the land, basically, from Stanford. So Stanford had a bunch of land, and they gave it to, or they loaned it, basically, out to Shockley. So Shockley started Shockley Semiconductor, and he hired people, among others, two people, Gordon Moore and Robert Noyce. They're from the East Coast. So, and a couple other folks as well. Well, what happened was, after Shockley got a third of the Nobel laureate, basically, he changed and he became, not a good manager anymore, basically, right? As the story goes. So these traitors ate. What they did is they signed a dollar bill, and Arthur Rock said, he made a list of people who out there wants to invest in these eight people, these eight smart individuals who want to start a company. And the company was Fairchild. So they started Fairchild Semiconductor. Now, Fairchild Semiconductor, there was another branch as well. So the semiconductor part of Fairchild was actually funding the other part. And so Robert Noyce and Gordon Moore were one of the traitors eight. And afterwards, these two individuals started Intel. So from the traitors eight, you have Applied Materials, you have Intel, you have AMD, among other entities. So the other part of it is Arthur Rock. Well, he helped fund Apple. He got the initial funding for Apple. He got the initial funding, of course, for Intel, of course, as well. Now, one of the other individuals that worked at Fairchild Semiconductor was Bob Valentine. So Bob Valentine, he was part of Sequoia Funding. Sequoia Funding was this venture capitalist, right? They funded Cisco, and they also funded NetApp. And a couple other, big names you may know out there. And so Mike Mularkey, he came from Intel, right? So Mike Mularkey is important because he helped, he was one of the co-founders of Intel. Him and Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak started Apple. Excuse me. So you see how all these things kind of play together. So the story goes that Robert Noyce is basically the godfather or the mayor of Silicon Valley, basically. Anytime you wanted your idea blessed, is it good? You want to get the blessing from the godfather, essentially, of Silicon Valley, you go to Robert Noyce. And that's his legacy at Intel in the Silicon Valley. He's well known to a lot of individuals. What I say is they're the starting of that, right? Basically, and I know Charles Babbage as well. He goes back almost 150 years or something like that, where he started he started something like a census counting machine, where he gave up, and then what became IBM started it back again. And of course, you know how IBM turned out. But so before Intel, right? in the Silicon Valley, you had HP, which they started the Palo Alto Research Lab, I think it was. Now, some of you may or may not know this. So a lot of people think that Microsoft stole the idea from Apple, right? Which is probably true, right? Well, what people don't know is Apple stole the GUI from Xerox, right? And then Xerox stole it from somebody else way back. There's a YouTube video out there. I might put it on the show notes that actually shows this individual with a GUI, playing around with the GUI and how it works. But so Palo Alto, Xerox or Palo Alto also had you know, what we call a computer way back in the day. And yeah, so that's a little history on the worldwide technology, World Wide Web. Once again, happy birthday to the World Wide Web. And thanks, everybody, for listening to this podcast, and have a great day.